A lot of people have made the assumption, a lot of gay men have made the assumption that because we have ARVs, or as we call them in this country, highly active antiretrovirals, that somehow if we become HIV infected, all we need to do is take the drugs and the drugs work. The drugs do work, but not for everyone, and they work at a cost. If you're one of the people, the lucky people who are able to tolerate the drugs, they still have quite incredibly overwhelming effects and impact on your lives. You can't say that it's like popping any other medication, because these are new drugs. We don't know long-term what they're going to be doing, but even short-term, they have very, very serious side effects. If people who are having, if gay men who are having unsafe sex now think it doesn't matter because we have a selection, we have a menu, a la carte menu of 20, 30 combinations of heart or ARV from which we can pick and choose, it doesn't work that way. You're not choosing the best wine in the restaurant. What you are choosing is the least or the best tolerated drug that has the least impact on you. I've known people who've gone through the entire menu, who've drunk the last dreg of the last bottle and haven't been able to tolerate any of the drugs, and then they've gone on to die. I've known people who've done well for a while and then not done well for all as a result of being in the drugs for a while. And for instance, at one time we had this thing called a drug holiday where you could come off your medication, so they said, and let your body recover. Now they find if you do that, it stops the medication working. You can't go back on it. Your HIV becomes resistant to it. I have people who have become HIV infected recently, who are newly infected, and they have been tested, and they've been found that the strain of HIV they've been infected from is multi-drug resistant. They aren't able to take many combinations because they've taken someone's HIV into their system that is already drug resistant. That's another danger of barebacking. If the person you're having sex with infects you with multi-drug resistant HIV, you're fucked in more ways than one. So if people think the drugs are a way into a rosy future, they aren't. They're very problematic drugs. And let's call the drugs what they are. The drugs are chemotherapy. That's exactly what they are, chemical therapy, chemotherapy. In cancer, you don't find people use any other words except chemotherapy. Let's call them chemotherapy. And then people might think, hey, do we want to be on chemotherapy when we don't need to, when we can avoid it by playing safe and staying safe? I think the language that we use is important. It's chemotherapy. It's not popping pills. It's chemotherapy for life. And that's been unheard of in medicine. You know, everyone on these chemotherapeutic drugs are pioneers. It's the first or second wave of the generation taking these drugs now. So we don't know the long-term effects because we haven't been there long-term. We are in the period of approaching short to mid-term. Long-term, we don't know what the drug's going to be doing.